How many years? Well, that's what it's saying. Huh? Bu mu? Hayır, buradaki sorular sebebi çok basit. Kesinlikle. Sebebi çok basit çünkü şu an anlatacağım 15 dakika. Doğrudan doğruya verdim. Ödevin son sorusu ile ilgili olduğuna göre olmak zorunda. Ödev dahil olduğuna göre. Bu 15 dakika var.
O soruyu da generalizasyon yapıp çözememeliyiz
tabii. Tabii tabii. Tabii canım yani sadece bu bir anlamda o soruda yaptığınızı kontrol etmeniz için yapıyorum. Tahminen yapabilirsiniz zaten de. Yani generalizasyon da anlatacağım o yani. Sadece bir yöntemi göstereceğim genel. Yani yaptığımızı kontrol edelim. Systems. Of equations.
Higher order
bilmem ne anlayacaksan ne tatlı var? Higher order dediğim orada en sona kadar en sorudur. En sorudur tartıştık. Doğru mu? Systems of equations. Şuna kadar sizde gördüğüm en sorudur. Single and order nonlinear equation diyoruz.
Sence
o
yanlış
mı
oluyor?
Yani
bir
equation'a
çevirsek
orada... Öyle yapabilirsin sen. Yani böyle yapmak istiyorsan... Ha, böyle yapmak istiyorsan öyle yaparsın. Yani daha epey daha uzun bir yöntem o ama öyle yapabilirsin. Doğru. Bir çözüm o. Bir çözüm. Madem ki onu yaptım ben biliyorum diyorsun. Bunu alıp end order'a çevireceksin önce. Ondan sonra yapabilirsin. Bir çözüm o. Ama genellikle daha güzel çözüm tam tersine modern yaklaşım dediğimiz daha pratik görüyoruz. Çok kompakt bir representation var bunun. Yani komünikasyonu da kolay. Daha güzeli tam tersini yapmaktır. End order varsa onu önce single end order varsa end first order'a çevirip halledilmek daha güzel tam tersi. Bunu öyle başlamanın sebebi o daha klasik bir şeyleri. The general procedure is the same general procedure approach. Linearize the system, the model in n variables. You should do an n variable, tailor the linearization in n variables. So it will. For instance, in two variables, it will look like this, right? For example, in two variables, second order, I will give you a general formula later, and I will just give you in two variables. We have, let us say, f1, well, in two variables, what does it mean? It means like this, x1 dot equals 1. f1 of x1, x2, and x2 dot equals 1. f2 of x1, x2, we agree? This is nonlinear second order system of equations. So then it looks like this, f1 of x1, x2, is equal, approximately equal, linearized now. This is how you linearize it. If you use, we have already seen Taylor equation, Taylor's expansion in two variables. And if you apply, you get this. x1 minus x1 equilibrium times partial of f1 with respect to x1, x1 equilibrium, comma x2 equilibrium, plus the other one, right? x2 minus h2 equilibrium partial of f2 with respect to h2 x1 h2 equilibrium. Do you agree with this? Take a look at the same theory. And then f2 x1 minus h1 equilibrium partial of f2 respect to x1, relative to x1 equilibrium, x2 equilibrium, x2, plus x2 minus x2 equilibrium, x2 minus x2 equilibrium, x2 minus x2 equilibrium, x2 minus x2 equilibrium,
Now the rest, of course, I am omitting the rest because I have linear
right. This is two variable Taylor linear regression. Do you agree? So that's perhaps what you use for general you are going to use. Now, of course, I'm not going to write for n variables. Now, for n variables, you can meet it. What's the only difference? X1, X2, dot, 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 xn. This is the same. This is the same. Plus, dot, 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 plus.
I'm sure. Can you call this F?
Of course, for the second one, I'm linearizing F1 only. So, dot, 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 plus xn minus xn equilibrium times partial of f, once again f1, evaluated at the equilibrium. Of course, these would be then again what? N variables, right? xn equilibrium. Right? So that's, you can apply the third order of most of the whatever. And to see just a quick example, let's see, there's several examples here. Let me show you. Let's see this one. Let's see, this is an ecological model. This is called some sort of competition model. A competition model. Ecological competition model. Population ecology model. This one looks like this. Dx over dt let me write then I well minus let us call it minus. Minus A minus dy times h dy over dt equals r m minus y times y minus n xy. And let's take a look at the meaning of this. Okay, so all coefficients, so a, b, r, m, n are positive coefficients, constants. X is a species 1, population of species 1, first species. The property of the species is the following. This is a competition model. What does it mean? They compete for the same food. So they harm each other, right? The causal relation is such that what? When one increases, the other one tends to decrease. It's harmed by the other one, right? Because there's competition. They are competing for the same finite resource or food source. So, and why is population of species 2? And the property is this. When alone, species 1 is such that it's not, let us say, sustainable. Because when left alone, it's what? Dying down, right? Do you see? So, by alone, it is declining, right? How do you prove that? If you put your hand on y, if you say y is 0, there is no y, in the absence of y, dx over dt equals what?
Minus a.
Minus a, so it means alone, it's already decaying. So this is not a, this is a kind of threatened, endangered species. Okay? Whereas y, the second species does what? When alone. Put your hand on x. What does the other one do? Huh? Wow. Yes, you don't have to take the exam anymore. It's the only topic we know, and then you know it, so that's it. Right? If there is no X, second species does what? density dependent growth.
What does this mean? This grows until y becomes 1.
M. So it's a fairly simple model. That's why I chose this one.
It's quite nonlinear though. I mean, it's strongly nonlinear because both are nonlinear. There's nonlinear term here. There is nonlinear term here. You know, there's one nonlinearity due to interaction, one linearity, the other nonlinearity. So it's a quite nonlinear model, but it's fairly easy to guess what will happen. So that's why we are going to check our results intuitively. Right? So the question is, what happens? Do they have equilibrium points and are they stable? Right? So what are the equilibrium points? What are the equilibrium points? From the first one, for xc, so let us say x dot equals 0, means implies what? Minus a plus by equilibrium, x equilibrium equals 0. From here, what do you get? What are the possibilities? X equilibrium is 0, or y equilibrium equals
minus.
Minus. Okay. So I will eliminate this in a minute. Why? Because that's not a tree. Possible
population that.
Why not? Because if you factor out y, what do you get here? R. You factor out y, right? M minus y. Minus, is this correct? Correct? Equals 0. And from here, what do you get? Y could be 0. Possible? That's one bar. So what's the other one? Is there another one? Well, the other one is, go back to the first one. In the first one, if x is 0,
why is that?
Huh? Y has to be what?
At 0.
If x is 0, put your hand here. If x is 0, y can be 0. That's what?
Or y can be m.
Or y can be m. Do you agree? And if, well, this one we are
thinking possible. Let's forget about it.
So from the first one, if x has to be 0, then in the second one, we have no choice for x. Do you see? There is no x choice there. So the only other possibility is what? If x is 0, then y is what?
M.
So there are, so and y is m. Y equals m, x equals 0. So the bottom line is what? What are my equilibrium points? One or two? Huh? They are 0, 0, and? Huh? 0, n. So either both of them will go to what? Extinction. Do you agree? That's the physical meaning. Or the first one will go to extinction, the second one will go to n. Okay, so just to do the mechanics of it, let us now see, can you guess which one will be stable, which one will be unstable? From the physical meaning and your deep knowledge of these models, can you guess? This one will be unstable, and this one will be stable, because the first one always wants to go to zero, and the second one, in the second one, we know that in general n is stable. So we can guess that, although there are some terms here, we can guess that this should be probably what? A stable equilibrium point, and this should be an unstable equilibrium point.
Alright.
So let us do this. Well, if you apply this idea. So the way we do it, so mathematically, stability. So this is stability. We are going to linearize, so you will find all these derivatives, right? My f is what? This is my f1, this is my f2.
I say something like this. Partial of F1 with respect to what? X equals minus A minus dy. Partial of F1 with respect to y equals minus dx. That's the first line, right? The second line is partial of F2 with respect to x equals minus my. And partial of F2 with respect to y equals Rn minus 2 Ry minus Nx.
That's the situation. Alright. So now I can linearize using this two-variable Taylor's expansion. So what do I get? I get F1 of xy is approximately equal to y. I have to see which one I am analyzing. I can analyze, I must analyze one by one what? 0 and around 0, 0. This one says what? I'm now analyzing the stability of the first equilibrium. So, 0, 0. So around 0, 0, I get something like this. X minus 0 times minus 8, right? Yeah. This evaluated was at what? 0, 0. Plus y minus 0 times straight 0. Minus dx, correct? No. Minus ax, minus ax. Okay. Right? Is correct?
Yes.
And what's the other one? F2?
So y equals to what approximately? X minus 0 times what? 0 plus y minus 0 times? Plus? What? Is Rm? Huh? So the result is Rm y. Now, what are we going to do next? Find? Finalize. Tell me what did you do? Linearize. This is what? Linearize, right? Now I go to my theorem of stability of linear systems. What do I do? Yeah, you can solve it, but you don't have to solve it. You can do it much faster than solving it. You check the eigenvalue. So find the eigenvalue. Now, so what do you do for that? You write down the A matrix, right? The A matrix is what? A matrix is what? A is 0, no, not 0.
Minus A.
Minus A. 0. 0. Now look, I'm not going to do any work. You can do the work, but when you look at this, can you immediately see the eigenvalues just by inspection? It is what?
A.
It is minus A. And the other one is Rm. Now, why? You see, because what we call this the decoupled system. Do you see how the system is decoupled? The two equations have nothing to do with each other. This just happens to be that way, the simple system. When you linearize it, you obtain what's called a decoupled system. Why is it decoupled? Because there is no y in the first one and there is no x in the second one. So what does it mean? When it's decoupled, you analyze them one by one, right? So there's the first order equation, which is what? X dot equals, and what are they after all? X dot equals what? Minus ax, and y dot equals Rmy.
you don't have to do matrix analysis here. The eigenvalues, first one is minus 8, second one is what? Rm. So you don't wanna, if you don't believe me, you can check it out. Lambda 1 is minus 8, lambda 2 is what? Rm. Therefore, what's your conclusion? Huh? 0, 0. Why? Because I'm assuming that these constants are positive. Right? And the other one is a little bit longer. So then you do around. What's the other one? 0 m. This is slightly longer. So that this one looks like this. Dx over dt is approximately equal to x minus 0 times minus a minus bm plus this time y minus m times 0 y minus m times 0, right? Okay, then you put in what? 0 and m to get Gelmedi mi? Denk gelince şükür diyor bakalım. Şöyle bir çeksin. Ha? Y minus, I think I made a mistake here. Y minus M, right? There's no mistake here, right? Rm minus 2 Rm, right?
Minus Rm. It's minus Rm.
Oh yeah, that's correct. Yeah, what I did was correct. But you see, what I said was this is equal to... yeah, I said this is equal to, which is much better than this representation. I said this is minus Rm times Z. Yeah, that's what I said. So the test is much easier. In other words, they say dz over dz equals what? Minus nmh minus nmz. But it's the same thing, of course. So you do whatever you want to do, you find the eigenvalues. Now I'm not going to spend too much time here. But if you find the eigenvalues, once again, the eigenvalues from the first one, you can directly write. The first one is decoupled. You see, so once again, find the eigenvalues. Lambda 1, lambda 2. Now, I can tell you that obvious. Lambda 1 is what? Minus a plus bm. Which is less than what? This is a real number?
Yes.
And is it negative?
Yes.
Yeah. So this is a negative real number. What about lambda 2? Well, lambda 2, that one you have to solve it. You can solve it. Huh?
Minus.
Yeah. You get minus Rm. Because that, once you find this one, then you can find the other one. Okay, so, and what's this one then? This is also negative. Why is it Jacobian? Because all it is what? It is really the partial derivatives evaluated at the equilibrium point. The Jacobian found at what? At the equilibrium point. So, the bottom line of all this, if you program this, if you write a computer program, what do? You take a nonlinear nth order system, which is nonlinear, you find what? Jacobian matrix at the equilibrium point. And then that tells you, if you are lucky, the stability, which you don't get on the borderline. Here is the borderline situation you must analyze. So you may want to write down in general, for an nth order system, so what you find, this one is, as I said, Jacobian matrix. Yes. Your Jacobian matrix becomes the A matrix of the linear axis. Okay. We'll see more examples later, of course. Okay.
Yeah?
Bunun denemeden sonra olabilir ama high order olsaydı,
tam
torcu olsaydı, bir denemeden sonra yine yapabilirdim. Tamam, tekrar bir tane bilmiyorum. Şimdi x kaçar, bir derivatif, x çarpı, derivatif, x çarpı. Derivatifler sayı olduğuna göre, baştan şey çıkar, bir derivatif. Okay? The only problem with this, the derivatives don't exist.
And then you have trouble.
You are not discussing the function. And you have to take the piecewise functions to find where they are differentiable. So that's the last situation. That's another little interesting research topic, for instance. You know, take some system dynamics models and see whether in general they have differentiable functions, these functions that you have. You have all these nonlinear functions and graphical functions. Can you come up with a general little package or procedure that automatically linearizes the system dynamics model? And if you have non-differentiable functions, can you approximate and find an approximate solution? So that's another little research question. Yeah, you can use limits or you can you know, divide the, you can do kind of different regions analysis. Ultimately, you're interested at the equilibrium point. So, you know, you're trying to find somehow, some way of, by taking limits or somehow, by analyzing those functions, you know, somehow find a healthy way of approximating the behavior of the derivatives. So, you know, if it's not differential, how can we approximate, how can we estimate that sort of. The bottom line is to reach the stability. So you work backwards from that. Yeah. Even if you cannot, the question is, if you cannot take the derivatives, can you do something there so that you can reach a healthy conclusion about stability? Can you somehow replace the derivatives, something that you usually measure? So that happens rarely, right? But it does happen, sometimes it happens.
Okay. Now we'll go back to, from this point on, you don't have to listen anymore. So, because it's not included in the graph. So this is now phase claims of systems. Phase claim or analysis. Phase analysis, phase planes are also used in single nth order equations, but that's rare. Phase planes really are designed, or derived, or invented after the system representation became popular. You can also use phase planes to some extent in single nth order systems by deriving different, by plotting different derivatives, you know. The first derivative with respect to x, then the second derivative with respect to first derivative, second derivative with respect to x, so forth. Different derivatives with respect to the state variable. By doing that, you can do some sort of phase analysis in classical nth-order representation as well. But as you see, the most popular usage, really, we mentioned, is motivated by the value in systems. Let me motivate it this way. Now, analyzing a system means, recall that at the extreme, Sen diyorsun ki kafayı mı yiyorsun? Ben gece yarısı bayağı merak ettim ya. Diyorum ki şimdi acaba bir e-mail mi atsam? Yani gece yarısı. Çünkü şey deyince rahatsız oldum. Önce aldın mı? Birincisi koy derler. Onlar kız diyordun Amerika'da. Önce koy diyordun